Skateboarding also teaches me how to deal with myself and my emotions. It helps me to know how to let everything out and just focus on what I'm living in the moment.
I broke my foot like 8 months before the Olympics. Here was the place that I was coming every single day after I broke it.
She was improving so fast, but getting hurt so much. More she gets hurt, more she wants to do it. So if you get hurt and you have to stand up again and do it again, it's a lot of effort for that. She works really hard.
I don't imagine myself like living in any other place. For me, here is the best place in the world. I love Floripa. They call here the Magic Island. And I truly believe in the energy and the magic. Almost my last name, you see? Asp. Almost. My first, my second, and this is the first deck that I skate this book.
A Yndiara, quando era bebê, ela era muito séria. Mas não era de braba, é que era muito concentrada em tudo. Ela era observadora, concentrada, né? Tinha... Desde pequenininha, assim.
Here. We have my brother and me with my first skateboarding. You can see just a little, but the glasses.
How old were you there?
Probably 7. And here too with my brother and my cousins.
Era uma criança bem tranquila desde bebezinho. Era aquele bebê que eu sentava ela com um monte de brinquedo, ela ficava o dia inteiro ali sozinha, sem interagindo, né, com os brinquedos, assim, bem tranquila.
That's my brother, bro. Bro. Man, that's my brother. He's 5 years younger than me, so now he's 19.
Ah, eu fico em choque, né? Pra mim... Eu sou apaixonado por isso, por ela, eu fico... Ah, nem sei o que eu falar, não sei o que eu falo.
Tá ótimo. That's my brother. That one. That now is bigger. I always get nervous skating at contests. Always. I like this pressure, this energy. It makes me do stuff that I don't do usually, so... This one's from Vans Park Series in São Paulo, Brazil. It was very special. It was the first contest that I bring together my parents to another city. This one was my first trophy. The place was called Tigela Skate Club. I was skating for 3 months. Yeah, but I did my first dropping in this place, and then I started going there every single day. I was 15. Actually, my story with skateboarding starts when my dad gave me my first skate when I was 7. And I was used to play just for fun here in the garage. I would love to play a lot of sports though. I used to surf with my dad since I was a little kid.
Ela surfa, jogava futebol, ginástica olímpica, natação, basquete, pular corda, perna de pau, assim, sempre amarelinha, sempre brincamos muito assim com atividade física, assim, a família inteira.
When we used to go like on weekend to some parks and like play all the sports we could, we would take skateboarding, bikes and play together all of the sports. And I always dreaming of learning to dropping, but it was something that seemed like impossible. And one day, my sports teacher from school, he invited me to go to this place. They had just opened it, And I went there, and that day I learned to dropping, and that feeling was the best feeling ever. And that feeling of like overcoming my fear made me want to go skate every single day after that day.
Ela sempre foi muito dedicada, então, por exemplo, ela foi, capoeira, ela foi em todas as faixas de capoeira, ginástica olímpica, ela também era legal, mas se identificou mesmo, ela gostava muito do surf, mas se identificou com o skate, assim. O skate, ela, acho que o skate escolheu ela, assim.
E daí é mostrar aí.
Bem?
Tudo certo? Ó, oh, trouxe um shape pra você que eu queria te dar há muito tempo já. Limpão.
Obrigado, hein?
Porra, que devo pra caramba, precisava. Né? Here is the place I did my first dropping. Can you see why? Because it's not like weird. It's not a transition like this. It's more like mellow.
Her first drop. I remember that. 2012, July.
And how did you two meet?
Our school teacher. Sports school teacher that made it happen. Some days it was like so hot, summertime, and he and his friends were jumping in the pool, and I would come here and skate alone with all my pads.
Eu sempre falo pessoal, né, que esse nem índia dropar.
He's saying he was the one who had teach me how to drop in. So he always is saying to his friends like, I'm the one that teach me how to drop in. Nice.
Ó, oh, aí, ó. Show. Uhul. Grande Indy.
That was so special to come back here after all those years. And I'm glad I had the chance now. Just to thank this family for everything they have done. And because of them, I'm here too. You have a culture here. When you turn 15, you have to do a big thing, like a big party or travel to somewhere. My grandma had just sold a piece of land, so she had some money to give to me, and I told her I want to build a skate park, like a bowl. So the bowl was right here. My dad built it.
Do meu irmão e fiz para ela um bowl de concreto pequenininho, assim, mas eu não sou skatista nem pedreiro, então ficou bem ruim, assim, e demorou muito tempo para fazer, foi quando ela começou a andar de skate.
Was so hard to skate. Was so small, so tight and so fast the walls. Was the beginning of everything. So thanks to my grandpa, my grandma, my dad, my mom, my family, my whole family that helped me out since the beginning. Oh, here. It's similar, but it's kind of different how it turns out. You see the idea. And it's super fun to be able to skate at my home and bring my friends and do the thing I love the most at my house. Oh, yeah. You broke it more. Break it more. That's all right. It's all done, all right. He always does that. Could never skate without shoes. Really. Dois, três, quatro, cinco, seis, sete, oito, nove. Quase foi nove.
I feel like she just like loves to have fun. Like truthfully, like you can tell that she's like, I just want to learn skateboarding. I love skateboarding. It's just her energy that she brings to it is so pure and so legit. Like she truly loves it and she just wants to get better. Her front 50s are, instead of like in the ramp, you know, in 50-50, and she's like fully on top and will ride it down, just so good. She also knows how to take a slam. I love people who know how to take a slam.
It took me.
She hypes you up, you hype her up, and it's like this mutual just like energy that you know you're gonna have a good time when you're standing with her. And
mar. Calmo não faz bom marinheiro, né? Então a dificuldade torna, né? Torna pessoas melhores também.
At the time I started skateboarding, my mom and my dad, they were fighting a lot.
Me separei da mãe dela. Uhum. E aí fiquei morando aqui com os dois, assim, era uma coisa meio diferente. Os dois vivendo só com o pai, sem a mãe em casa, assim. A Indy tinha 15 e o Yuri 10.
They are like getting the divorce. So it wasn't like a good environment at my home that time. And I started skating, so it was the best for me because skateboarding also teaches me how to deal with myself and my emotions, and it helps me to know how to let everything out and just focus on what I'm living in the moment.
Pai e mãe separando, então com certeza o skate ajudou totalmente, assim.
O skate era o refúgio dela. Era um...
Isso foi bem quando ela começou a andar.
Foi,
assim.
foi um propulsor, né, na verdade. Assim, ela
focou
no skate e fugiu dessa.
Skateboarding is my lifestyle. It's where I can be myself and I feel freedom. After my dad and my mom divorced, we stayed with the house and my mom stayed with the car. So we used to go everywhere in the motorcycle. My dad used to take me to the college, to the skate spot, like with the backpack, the skateboard, everything. And then thanks to skateboarding, I bought my first car.
Florianópolis was nothing. There was only native people living, like fishmen, fish guys, and that's it.
This street is so long. I used to come here by bus. I always wished here was a good like skate ground. I always like hope someone that I knew would pass here by car so he could give me a ride.
The big secret about Florianópolis, especially that area here, the RTMF, is the open door. Always was open up for everybody to skate. Once you have that, everybody can participate in it, and they can see what it is for real, you know?
Let's go. High Adventure Tour right now.
Eu cheguei em Florianópolis em 1994, né, e a gente iniciou o nosso empreendimento aqui em 1997.
Here we have the store, the bar, place to hang out.
É mais comercial e nesses quase 30 anos que a gente existe já passou muita coisa por aqui, né? Tipo, já a gente tem escolinha hoje de skate, né? A gente tem aulas para criança carente, né? Para galera em geral e assim é a vida do skatista, né?
Then here is the best part of it. The Red Bull, the classic. This bowl is so good. It's my favorite. For sure. And it's the favorite bowl of a lot of people. Oi, e aí, tudo bem? E aí? Our skate scene, it's very strong here. You can see all the kids.
Quando ela chegou aqui, pouco praticado até, não existia tantas meninas praticando o skate como praticam hoje.
E tinha que pagar, e eu não tinha por dia para andar, eu não tinha dinheiro, aí eu falei com o Rafael, o dono, que eu tinha dois filhos e que não tinha dinheiro para pagar a diária, mas tinha para eles gastar com alimentação lá, e eles, não, menina não precisa pagar, menina aqui não paga, a gente incentiva as meninas e pode trazer o teu menino sem pagar também.
And Rafa was, no, come on, girls, they can skate for free, they don't have to pay, and yeah, bring your son also. We don't used to have many girls skating, and if you give them the opportunity, it's gonna be easier to bring more and more girls together, right? It was like a an open door for me, so it can be for so many other girls.
E aí ela começou, ela participou do nosso primeiro campeonato feminino, que a gente fez do RTMF Number One, feminino exclusivamente, ela participou. E a partir disso ela começou, a gente começou a disponibilizar para ela o treinamento aqui junto com a gente.
Então, aqui na Raia de Ventre já fazem 11 anos que eu estou dando aula. Então, a Indy foi uma das primeiras alunas que eu tive aqui, junto com a Isa também, mas ela começou um pouquinho mais tarde, 14 anos, mais ou menos. O cara se tornou muito dependente, eu acho, de ter um professor. E você estando sozinha, você evolui um pouquinho mais lento.
Eu conheço a Indy desde 2012. E a gente se encontrou pela primeira vez aqui nesse lugar, que é a Raia de Ventre. Então ela já está comigo há uns bons anos aí. A nossa amizade, ela é na base de uma evoluir junto com a outra. Então a gente está sempre aprendendo uma com a outra, sempre dando os toques. E todo esse momento que eu passei com a Indy, eu aprendi muita coisa na minha vida. Irmã mais velha para mim, então ela já me ensinou muita coisa. Ela tem muito mais experiência do que eu, então ela está sempre me ajudando no dia a dia. E eu fico muito feliz com essa troca que a gente tem.
Nitidamente ela se destacou, assim, já. Ela aprende com muita facilidade, percebeu que ela aprendia com muita facilidade. E ela já ganhou uma evolução bem rápida, assim. Em pouco tempo andando de skate, ela já estava na frente, assim. Já.
My name is Yndiara Asp. I am 19 years old and I'm from Florianópolis, Brazil.
So it was on my third trip down to Brazil, to Florianópolis. I was with Bob Denike, who's the CEO. So I was super excited to show him how rad Florianópolis was and what a great scene Eduardo has down there with the whole posse at RTMF and High Adventure and all of that. That's where I met Indy for the first time. We had the mini ramp to ourselves and we just had a little skate session in the evening and was immediately impressed. She was just ripping.
Foi o próprio Paul da NHS, quando esteve aqui me visitando, olhou ela andando no bowl e falou assim, nossa, essa menina é muito boa, você devia patrocinar ela. Foi muito legal isso aí, sim. Acho que foi até por isso que eu passei a olhar com mais atenção para ela, até e para as outras meninas também.
It was so hard for me before to buy a deck.
So sick.
Use the deck to the very end of it for a long time.
I love pink. This one's so sick.
It took me a long time to like use it just a little and then change it.
I was the guy doing deals, like managing her. And once I did my first deal with Red Bull, I told the guy, I said, look, she won't be the girl to win contest, but she's the girl. We were signing the contract and it was in the Vans Pack Series in Brazil. And she got second place and was like, well, and she went, well, Andre, you told me she would never be in the podium. I said, no, man, sorry, but that surprised me too. And they were like, no, yeah, let's get her in the team right now.
You know, she started doing contests and winning contests, and that's how she kind of got on Andrew and Pizzle's radar.
Oh, well planned.
And the crowd is wild.
Oh, wow.
For her to be one of the first women's Olympians in skateboarding park. Like, I have chills right now because it's so cool.
Andy, over that hip front side ollie. Foot plant off the step back bench.
I think the most special moment from the Olympics was coming back to the island. From Pedro was with the medal. Everyone was just, wow!
It's a Fabi's model. I gave the board I was riding at the Olympics to Rafa, to Pousada.
Just got framed and he's going to put on the wall.
Eu acredito que hoje em dia, para qualquer skatista no mundo inteiro que estiver começando, vai ter muito mais oportunidade do que se tinha antes das Olimpíadas, por exemplo. Eu acho que as Olimpíadas vai ser um grande divisor de águas entre o que foi o skate e o que vai ser o skate.
We had the chance to show them we are so connected to each other and how we do it with love, with respect, with
a lot of values.
Once she realized where she could go with skateboarding, she went like hot. From that day, first day I saw her, was all about skateboarding. She knew that she could change her life.
So turning Yndiara pro was magic.
Once you see her like react, you can yell surprise. Just don't say it before she sees it, okay?
It was awesome. I mean, we had everyone from the company that could come, be in the museum and holding up the boards and yell surprise. What people don't realize is how much time, how much energy, and how much work goes into it, and that it never turns off. For her to have that experience and to be able to feel those kind of feelings of like all the hard work, all the time, all the energy, all the sacrifice, for her to be able to just celebrate that moment, I felt was so special.
I love it, thank you. An honor and big dream come true.
Santa Cruz me abraçou, acreditou em mim quando eu estava aprendendo, dando meus primeiros drops. E agora eles me reconheceram como skatista profissional, lançaram meu pro model e tão lindo assim desse jeito. Eu estou muito feliz e realizada e muito grata mesmo. Muita gratidão pelo skate, pela Santa Cruz, por todo mundo que envolve. Todo mundo que faz parte, minha família, meus amigos, vocês, a família Santa Cruz, a família do skate. Só gratidão ao universo, a tudo isso. Obrigada!
I would say 5 years ago, it was like Nora and Lizzie, you know, and Leticia. So like, what, 3 girls out of like however many girls were skating. We're making enough to like skateboard every day. Now it's like probably like 20 of us or more who are able to skateboard and make it our life. And it's so cool. I feel like women are gonna start to evolve at like a more rapid rate because we actually have opportunities to grow.
I'm gonna stay here.
No começo foi muito difícil, mas hoje em dia o sucesso dela mudou totalmente a nossa vida, né? Adquiri um carro, ajudou a me ajuda a pagar água, luz, as contas, sustentar a casa.
Yeah, I feel so grateful I'm able to give a better life for my family, help my family.
Uma gratidão assim que não tem palavras.
I'm here because of my family, so I would do anything for them, and I know they would do the same for me, so.
A Índia, assim, ela tem essa good vibe dela, assim, sabe? Que ela inspira o pessoal, assim, que ela é muito positiva, muito pra cima, então eu acho que só vem coisa boa pra ela, assim, só, né, ela tá no caminho do bem.
I think 100% of the girls here, they start skate park because of Indy. I have no doubt about it.
She's very, like, focused on her skating, but then like once she's done skating too, it's like she can have fun and party and like do whatever. So
ela é um super exemplo. Inclusive, ela já motivou, com certeza, ela já influenciou inúmeras meninas que estão começando. Não vai parar de crescer, então não vai parar de crescer, cara.
É uma skatista talentosa, tem muito carisma e é super profissional, super responsável. Então isso faz ela ser o que ela é hoje.
Yndiara is such a great role model because it's the way that she handles herself. She lives it, she breathes it, she sleeps it. Like, for her, she's skateboarding.
galera, Yndiara Asp aqui. Obrigado por assistirem esse vídeo. E para assistirem mais vídeos, não se esqueçam de se inscrever no canal, ativar as notificações. E assim vocês não perdem nenhum novo vídeo irado da Santa Cruz. Valeu, tamo junto, se cuidem.